I love the hives. That's the hives. They do to your ears what a shot of wasabi mustard does to your tongue. Zings it. We've got Jerome Flynn with us. The rugged good looks of Jerome Flynn are in the studio with me now. Jerome, thanks for coming in.
It's a pleasure to be here.
You're looking good.
Thank you.
You look well, you look rested, you look happy.
I am happy.
Good, that's nice to know, because I know you had a period where you weren't so happy, were you? You were a bit troubled and confused by life.
Was I? Did I tell you that last
time
I was on?
You did.
We have our times, don't we?
Everyone does.
Yes.
But now you're in a good space. And Jerome is currently starring in the West End as, and I'm excited about this, Tommy Cooper in Jus Like That. A kind of, I guess it's a comedy play stroke performance based on the great man's life and work. Would I be right?
Yeah, I mean, it's like, it's really a fest, really, of Tommy. It's like you're coming to see him in his prime, in the 60s and the 70s. But it's not, we don't go into, you know, deeply into his life or kind of uncover his dark side. We really just give you Tommy at his best.
So it's not a waltz and all kind of like, here's the shadowy real life of the man or whatever he was going through. Because I don't actually know much about his life. I don't know if he had a happy or unhappy life. I'm hoping it was happy, but it's not one of those kind of plays, is what you're saying.
No, and I don't think Tommy really uncovered himself much to the people that loved him either. He was he was a comedian, and he was always looking for the next gag and the next trick. And I got to know his wife a little bit, and he said even when he come home from the shows, he'd just carry on, and he was always trying out tricks on his kids, and we kind of do that in the show. We go backstage with him. And sorry, I think I've got to go. I feel like I've got to go to the toilet. I'm really sick.
You've got to go to the toilet. Okay, well, you got the toilet.
I'm sorry about this. I don't know what it is.
This isn't the Tommy Cooper routine you do.
No, it's not.
Well, you got to the toilet.
Do you mind?
Well, no, I'd rather you go to the toilet than here, frankly. Well, you got the toilet quickly.
Have you got a toilet?
Yes, we have. Tommy Cooper, we'll be talking about after Jerome has done whatever he needs to do in the toilet.
I think he was listening to your show before I came on.
Don't say that, or we won't let you go. That's a great song, and it's a great version. It's David Bowie, of course, Hang On To Yourself, and that's on my very old CD of The Man Who Sold The World. I don't know if it's on the new CD.
Probably remastered,
yeah,
I expect.
Jerome Flynn's back with us. You feeling okay now?
I'm terribly sorry about that.
That's okay, but it was quite exciting, quite dramatic. It was good fun. I mean, for us, not for you, probably. You okay now, though?
Yeah, I'm
fine. Dodgy food last night?
It's seeing you. I haven't seen you for such a long time.
I think sometimes we're a bit of an unpleasant, unwelcome sight. Do you have a favourite Tommy Cooper moment, a favourite line from his comedy that always makes you chuckle?
Oh, I love them all. I mean, but he tells his story of this time when he went to it's a true story. He went to back to Cairo, which is where he got his fez.
He actually got it in Egypt, did he?
Yeah,
I didn't know that
because he lost his pith helmet. He used to wear a pith helmet in the army in his act, and he lost it, and he had to have wear a hat. And a waiter walked by, and he grabbed it off the waiter. But he tells his story of how he goes back once he's famous, and there's a guy selling fezes in the market. He goes up to try one on, and the guy turns to him and he says, "Just like that." And he says, "How did you know that?" And he says, "Every time an English person comes to try a fez on, they always turn to their friend and say, just like that."
So that it was the word that everyone used, Tommy Cooper reference.
And then the guy said, "You're the first one not to say it."
That's so funny.
Isn't that beautiful?
He was. There was something about him which seemed to be, whether he wanted to be or not, comic, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, it was a bit Frankie Howard had the same sort of thing, I think. It was the way their face was arranged, it was the way they looked, the way they moved. And did he work at that, or was it kind of naturally, did the kind of comedy gift find him, do you think?
I think it was both. I think he was a very clever man, and he knew what made people laugh. But I think there was something about the spirit of him and the way he looked at life. Not just the way he looked, but the way his just view of life. He just encouraged people to let go, you know, and say, look, you don't have to look good. You don't have to be in control. You can get everything wrong, and it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
And isn't life, you know, just kind of relax, will you?
It was a sort of shambling, but it was charming.
Yeah, and I think that touches somewhere quite deep in us.
Did he use gag writers, or did he write much of his own material?
I think he was always on the lookout for gags, so I think he used gag writers, but then he made it his own.
Yeah.
And the same as he did with the tricks. You know?
Well, he could just say, I mean, I never met the man. I would love to have met the man. My brother Paul met him once when he was working, before he was doing TV, where he was working behind the scenes at London Weekend Television, and Tommy Cooper got in a lift with him and someone else. And they all, you know, when someone's super famous or you all admire gets in a lift with you, there's a frisson on, you all get quite excited.
Yeah.
And you could sense the atmosphere change. And obviously, Tommy Cooper's aware of this. Well, and they went up a few floors and he just said one simple thing, and they all burst out laughing. Whether or not it was many funny, he just, about 2 floors, he went, "My feet are killing me." And they all burst out laughing because it was... But it may well have been... I was thinking, how tragic if his feet were killing him.
Yeah.
And he just wanted to share.
Yeah, I know. He was... That was, I think everybody said he was as funny off stage as he was on. Yeah. And he never let up.
But fantastic. There's some fantastic footage of him. I mean, I'd like to see more of it on television today. There was a Royal Variety moment, which I've been told about, where apparently he'd done fantastically well. Everyone loved him. He'd stolen the show.
Yeah.
And he looked up at the Queen at the end, who was in the box, and said, Your Majesty, I can't do the voice. You could do the voice, presumably. Would you mind doing a bit for us in a minute?
Yeah, but I don't know the story, so I can't do that.
Well, you do that bit, and I'll do my voice, and people can fill in the gaps. But he apparently looked at the Queen and said, Your Majesty, do you mind me asking you a question or two? She said, no.
Oh, yes.
Said, did you enjoy the show? She said, did you think I was funny? She said, yes. She said, do you like football?
Yeah.
And she said, not really. And then he said, you know this line?
Yes.
He said, do you mind if I have your cup final tickets then?
Yeah.
Which is such a fabulous line.
Isn't that beautiful?
And I'm assuming that was probably an ad lib. I mean, I would have thought that he...
Apparently he might have nicked it off Bud Flanagan.
Oh, really? It was a...
But it takes courage to talk to the Queen like that.
I would have thought so. Hey, have you become more of a fan of him, more of a fan of comedy generally now that you're doing the show?
I love variety. And it's kind of made me think, oh, God, I could do... This is better than acting, you know?
Mm, yeah.
And I'd love to put a variety show together because people love it.
Wait, so you would do comedy yourself on stage? Well, as yourself or as Tommy still?
I don't know. I think in some kind of character. I like to have... I kind of feel protected.
Yeah, of course.
I mean, I certainly feel protected with Tommy in some mystical kind of way. I don't feel on my own out there. But I love... You know, I was brought up on, you know, Laurel and Hardy and... all the great duos, the great kind of Hollywood duos. And I love all that stuff. Yeah. And I think people, there's an innocence to that kind of comedy that I think is missing, you know, at the moment.
Yeah, and Tommy Cooper stuff as well. There aren't that many people. Although maybe some of the new comedians like Peter Kay and...
Peter Kay's good.
Yeah, and Johnny Vegas, even though, you know, the language is different. But, I mean, certainly I think there's something about their personas on stage which reminds me of these
guys.
Yeah,
absolutely. And I think we could do with a lot more of it, don't you?
It's interesting you're saying that when you're on stage... Yeah, I do think so. It's interesting when it's like you feel kind of protected. You feel kind of like he's there, his spirit. So you feel like you're in not in a kind of paranormal
without
way.
Without getting too... but I do.
You feel a connection?
Yeah, definitely. And I feel... And Simon Callow, who directed...
Simon Callow, the high-waisted trousers...
No, that's Simon Cowell.
Oh, I see. I'll get them mixed up. I'm sorry. Oh, Simon Callow, the actor. I'm sorry. Although I'd like to see Simon Callow on Pop Idol.
With high-waisted trousers.
Yeah.
Simon Callow...
No, doesn't that show me the bad light? I apologise.
he's wonderful, and he's a wonderful director as well. But we've felt throughout rehearsal that Tommy's been part of it. He's in on it, really. And we've kind of respected that. We thought, well, what would Tommy do if he had the chance to come back and do it? And... No, I know that, and things happen on stage that kind of inexplicable, just magical things, and things come out of my mouth, and I think, where did that come from?
Yeah. You know?
So that's all part of it, and it seems to be working.
So as an acting job, then, is this a different experience for you? Is it different to, because obviously you're always inhabiting other personas, you're always becoming other people when you're acting.
Yeah.
But it sounds to me like here there's something different going on, something which is you haven't experienced before, or is this a common?
I've never felt so free. On stage, but then again, I don't have to worry about the other actors in the cast. I've got six lovely dancing girls, but it's just me and the audience mainly.
So you can go almost wherever you want.
I kind of let go. Obviously, there's a whole set of tricks and gags which I have to get in, but the relationship with the audience is what excites me, and it's live and different every night. And there's so much joy and coming off the audience, and it just I feel like I can fly. It's beautiful.
Is it pretty full houses most nights? I imagine.
Well, it's a tough time in the West End anyway, but relatively we're doing really well, really well. But I just want to encourage more people to come along.
Yeah, well, I'm going to come along and see it, because my father-in-law, as I said, is a big... Stu, who's listening at home, he's a big Tommy Cooper fan. I was a big Tommy Cooper fan. And so, obviously, we can't see Tommy, but I imagine this will be the next best thing. And certainly, I know you've had some fantastic reviews for this, so you must be delighted with that reception.
I'm over the moon, but I think it's proof that there's something about the spirit of Tommy and, like you say, some of those old... It's like Eric Morecambe.
Mm, yeah.
So when I went to see the play, what I wrote, I wanted Eric back. I didn't care how they did it.
You want to see it?
And he did. He brought that guy... I've forgotten his name. He brought Eric back to life. And those times when he did, the audience, there was just like this release of joy.
Isn't that strange?
And I think that's why also people love doing Tommy so much. It's because something happens to them when they do it. They don't do a perfect impression. It doesn't matter, but there's something about the spirit of the man that comes through.
But physically, or facially at least, there is a resemblance.
That's what they say.
Yeah.
I got a big jaw, you see. I broke my jaw.
Also, the nose. You've got kind of a broken-looking nose as well.
I have.
And that benefits him.
Yes.
And the hair's a bit squiff, which he had as well.
Well, funny, it's gone curly since I started playing it. I know, I don't understand it.
Seriously, you haven't curled it? I thought you permed it for the part or something.
I haven't curled it, no.
Look at that. That's quite... Mm. That's a bit unsettling. Do you get a feel? I mean, studying for the part, presumably you watch tapes of him, I imagine, you read his material. Mm. But do you feel that you've got a sense of him as a person as well?
I think that's mainly what I feel I try and click into. I don't know. It's just like, well, I would love the man anyway. I felt an affinity with him since he died, funnily enough. I didn't really quite, when I was a kid, I didn't quite get it. I couldn't understand why he kept on getting everything wrong.
Yeah.
But, I found that when I'd had a few drinks at parties and I'd start doing spoon, jar, jar, spoon, and there's something about the nature of the man which I connect to.
Yeah.
And so I haven't been... It's not like this kind of studied impersonation. It's more like I feel like it's just a labour of love.
That being him. Yeah. Yeah, that sounds great. Yeah. I'm really keen to see the show. Let's play. Do we have time to play a track and then talk some more and then play another track?
We can play a short track and then you'll have to just say goodbye and do
Well,
some
why
more,
don't we just chat some more then and we'll play one track and go out, okay? So that's, we've worked out the show there, thank you.
Okay, that's right. You've got about a minute and a half.
We've had a number of disagreements today.
But we can have another quiz. That was good.
That was great, wasn't it? Yeah. Wonderful fun. What did you, seriously, honestly?
I was
quite
gripped
honestly,
out there.
Honestly, what did you make of it? It was terrible, wasn't it?
I think it might have been why I went to the toilet.
It was terrible.
You've got a minute now.
Don't get cross.
Well, you're losing your
don't
time.
Don't get cross. Jerome, what else is happening for you then? Are we going to see you back on TV? Are you going to do more of the sort of straight TV roles?
I'm so happy now. I'm kind of not thinking about what's coming next. And I've got a feeling this will lead... I don't know, you know, one thing leads to the other. And I'm not thinking about straight TV roles at the moment.
So there won't be a return of Badger, the pet detective. He's not necessarily coming back.
You loved that, didn't you?
I thought it was funny.
I know.
I thought you did a good job on it. It was a fine bit. It was exactly what it was meant to be, you know. And there's no, you know, it was. Yeah. But it was a funny concept.
It was a funny concept.
Yeah, but I'm not being dismissive of that kind of thing at all. I'm quite welcome seeing you in that sort of role. But I wonder whether you had more planned. That's what I was asking.
Not planned, but and I'd like this to run a while and to tour. I'd love to go to the places Tommy used to go to.
Yeah, but those places don't exist anymore. As such, I suppose those kind of old style music.
The towns.
Yeah,
and because there's a lot of people that can't make it down to London. I think and the reception when we toured. Before coming to London, the reception was wonderful.
I can imagine. Where was he born, Tommy Cooper?
He was born in Exeter.
Right.
No, he was born in Wales and moved to Exeter. And we went down to Plymouth. It was like coming home. It was beautiful.
It must be a wonderful thing to be on stage doing that and feel comfortable doing that. Do you take the character home with you, as they say? Do you ever find yourself slipping into Tommy, you know, unexpected
moments?
Well,
I'm quite clumsy.
Yeah.
But no, I try not to. Yeah. But my friends probably won't agree with that.
I think we're going to go to music now and see Andy looking quite cross there. He's all puffed up like a little...
I'm not.
Look like a little bull terrier. Jerome, really lovely to see you again. I'm sorry that we brought on a kind of involuntary gag reflex or whatever it was that gave away. Jerome Flynn is currently starring in the West End of London here in a play called Jus Like That. It's a kind of recreation of Tommy Cooper's work and life. It's at the Garrick Theatre in London. I'm going to try and go and see it this week, I think.
Great.
Monday, Tuesday this week. But if you're in town, I think it sounds like a terrific night out. Thank you so much for coming. It's really nice to see you again.
Been a pleasure, John.
What are we going to end the show on, Andy?
Bit of Small Faces.
Lovely.